Hi everyone, welcome to SurveyJS. My name is Elena and today we're going to learn more about text piping, what data sources can be used to generate pipe text, and of course I'm going to show you how easy it is to set up text piping within your SurveyJS form. Let's get started.
Text piping is a built-in feature of the SurveyJS Form Builder tool that allows you to make user experience more personal by using entered or selected text to create dynamic content for the subsequent questions or the thank you page. This basically means that you can take any user responses and dynamically form other survey elements down the line based on these responses.
As you can see, pretty much any survey element that requires data input can serve as a source element for pipe text.
To set up such a data transfer and make user input become part of the further interaction with the form, we first need to identify a source survey element from which we are going to pipe the input. A source element for text piping can be a question value, a row or column value. You can also pipe text from selected choice options or data entered in question items, for example, in multiple text boxes.
Once a source element has been identified, we then need to select a target element and specify the exact place where a dynamic text should appear. To do this, we are going to reference a source element ID within the target element using curly brackets. And for those who are using SurveyJS Form Builder for the first time and is not familiar with its settings, let's take a look at what survey element IDs are there, because survey elements differ and so do the properties that serve as IDs for those survey elements.
For example, if you generate pipe text based on a value of a single select question, such as a radio button group, then the text of a selected choice option will be piped into a target survey element. In this example, the target element is the title of a single input question, and the value of the name property, cuisine type, serves as a question ID, and it's this property that we've referenced within the dynamic title of the follow-up question. If our source element is a row of a single select matrix, as in this example, then we will be referencing the row ID to access the required row value. And then we will pass it to an item title of a multiple text boxes. The row ID is set up in the designer tab in the property grid under rows. And the left column here is for row IDs, and the right column is for display text that respondents can see. And besides row ID in the target element, which are item titles, as I said, of a multiple text box, we need to specify which question this particular row belongs to by adding a source question ID as a path to the source row value. And as you can see, both item titles contain a reference to the row ID and to the ID of its parent question. In the next example, we are sourcing data from items of multiple text boxes, and we are piping it into titles of two single inputs. So let's add another one, let's say English. And in order to set up a data transfer from items, we need to assign an ID for the parent question, which these items belong to. And in our case, we specified the question ID as subject ID, because we're talking about subjects here, but it can be anything else. And then we need to specify an ID for each individual item that we're sourcing data from. And in order to assign item IDs, we need to go to the property grid, and under items, we assign item IDs in the left column, and we assign display text that our respondents will see in the right column. And we also created two target elements, which are single inputs, and then in the dynamic titles of those target elements, we specified first the ID of a parent question and then an ID of a source item of our multiple text boxes. And the final example that I want to show you is how to pipe data from a question and then insert it in the custom text of your thank you page. For example, if I type my name here and then I'll just skip all question and I complete the survey, then you can see that my name appears at the thank you page. And obviously, if I type any other name here, then it will be updated at the thank you page as well. So this element of the thank you page text is dynamic. So in order to pipe text here, we need to go to the Designer tab and under Survey Level Settings, which are general settings for the whole form, we need to open the category called Survey Complete, and we need to find an input field with the title Survey Complete Page Markup. This is basically default text that any respondents will see when they complete your form or survey when they submit it. And to tweak it a little bit by adding the dynamic text, we do exactly the same as in previous example. We need to reference a source item ID in this within this text using curly brackets. So as you can see, my first question, what's your name, has an ID first name. And so if I go back to the survey settings, and then you can see that this exact ID is referenced here. And this is how it appears on the thank you page once the survey or form is submitted.
And that's all for today. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.